My name is Gunther Steinbrunner. I'm the hotel manager on board this beautiful Seabourn Sojourn, and we are very excited about our new build, and welcome on board.
If you're at all familiar with Seabourn Odyssey, you'll feel right at home on Seabourn Sojourn. The sister yachts are nearly identical. You'll see a little more of Sojourn in just a few minutes. But first, we need to go find Twiggy. Twiggy is godmother of Sojourn, and last Friday in London, she named the ship. That's her with Captain Carlo Buer. As I began my quest to look for Twiggy, the crew was preparing for the evening ceremonies, the christening event. There was ice to be carved, lots of ice, and also lots of food to be prepared, too, for the 450 guests. And of course, there was champagne to be uncorked as well. Unable to find Twiggy, I went to explore the ship and to get some impressions. My first stop was at the spa.
Hello, my name's Natasha Spence. I'm the Director of Operations for Steiner Maritime. Here on the Seabourn Sojourn, we're in the spa. This area here is the serene area, the heated chairs that you can relax in, and we've got the cocoon chairs. You can go out into the spa deck area and relax outside, and upstairs above we have a private spa deck area as well, where we have a spa
villa. I like the changes in the spa, and especially the spa villas. They do look like an ideal place to spend a day at sea. You can even have your lunch served there. At 6 o'clock, we all went out to the pool deck for the christening. There was no shortage of drink, including a unique way to serve vodka. It went through this beautiful ice sculpture, into a glass, and then into my hand. And of course, there was champagne, and of course, caviar. Next, I found Captain Carlo Buer, who was exceptionally proud on this day.
Being in the heart of London with a cruise ship like this for the inaugural event is quite unique. I'm not sure if there's been another one doing the same thing in London. So now we all look forward to this evening, and also we look forward to starting our maiden voyage out of London.
I met the architect Bjorn Storbrogen and his wife Anna.
I'm a little romantic, really. So I thought, wow, 5 years, you know, down the road, I'm here on this marvelous ship, which is, in my career, this is the peak of what I can do, you know.
And then I ran into Pam Conover, who is the president and CEO of Seabourn Cruise Line, and a native Brit. She couldn't have been prouder.
Oh, it's a fantastic experience. Being British and bringing this wonderful new ship into this wonderful city is just a moment that I will always treasure.
Pam gave a wonderful welcome to all of us, and we all waited for the big moment, the arrival of Twiggy.
In the heart of London.
And finally, the big moment, Twiggy was coming.
Welcome our wonderful godmother to our wonderful new yacht. Ladies and gentlemen, Twiggy.
Obviously, Twiggy was taking her time descending the stairs. I admit, at this point, I was getting a little bit nervous whether Twiggy would show up or not. But at last, there she came, descending the stairs like Scarlett O'Hara. Continuing that analogy, Sojourn was indeed Twiggy's tarot.
Welcome to my yacht. I was so thrilled and excited and proud to be asked to be the godmother of this beautiful, luxurious yacht. And I'd like to thank everyone for making me feel so welcome. I've named this yacht Seabourn Sojourn. May God bless her and all who sail in her.
And next came the champagne, crashing against the hull. Later that night, lots of us got to meet Twiggy. That's Mickey Aronson to the far right, chairman and CEO of Carnival Corporation. It's his yacht, technically. We celebrated on the upper deck with music, fireworks, more music and more fireworks. And then the highlight of the evening came for me, because I too got to meet Twiggy.